Racing to tackle the coronavirus earlier today, the New York Governor Andrew Cuomo made a hopeful announcement about a company in New York State that's already getting some results. Listen to this.
We're also working on a number of other drug therapies, an antibody therapy, possible vaccines. We have a company here in New York called Regeneron that is really showing some promising results.
And joining us now, Dr. Len Schleifer. He's the co-founder, president, and CEO of Regeneron Pharmaceuticals. You got a shout out also, Dr. Schleifer, from the president on Thursday when he said your company has done fantastically. So what are you doing now to A, come up with some treatments, and B, come up potentially with a vaccine?
Right. Thanks, Wilkin. Thanks for having us on. But first, let me just start. Thanks to all the people on the front line, and that includes Regeneron employees who literally are there now, who are risking their health so that we can try and move forward in this fight that we're hopefully going to win. And I think that what Regeneron is trying to do is implement the strategy that the whole industry is trying to do. It's a basic, simple, three-pronged approach. You start with what's on the shelf that we have now that we might be able to reposition, redeploy, use it for this coronavirus when it wasn't intended for that. The second approach is, what can we quickly get that might actually help people who are infected with this virus survive or prevent people from getting infected? And then, of course, there's the long-term solution, which we would all love to have, which is a vaccine, but unfortunately, that takes time. From our perspective,
finish your thought.
I was just going to say, from our perspective, we have two approaches. One is we have a drug that we're trying to see. It's a powerful anti-inflammatory immune-modulating drug. Those are big words, but really it means that can we calm down the lungs, which are in a massive state of inflammation reacting to the virus? And that we're in clinical trials right now. We've got dozens of people already enrolled, and we're trying to see as quickly as we can whether that drug will work.
Well, when you say as quickly as you can, what do you estimate the time for the treatment and then potentially a vaccine? Because we've heard Dr. Fauci say it could be a year, maybe a year and a half before an actual vaccine is approved.
Sure. So a vaccine may take a long time, but we have an approach that's in between that. So first of all, we have this approach to calm down the lungs. That will get results probably, I would say, within a month or so, maybe shorter. The midterm approach, which we're very excited about, is really the brainchild of our co-founder, George Yancopoulos, where he imagined that you could create mice. Imagine this when he was a graduate student 35 years ago. You could create mice that if you immunize them with a protein or a virus or something else, they would make human antibodies. And he's used that to make about 7 drugs already, and the most recent of which is to see if we could treat Ebola. We took a piece of the Ebola virus, we put it in these magical mice, and our scientists were able to find antibodies in there that were human antibodies that could neutralize the Ebola virus. And it was shown last year, overwhelmingly, that our cocktail, EB3, was able to cure people who had Ebola, and if you got to them early, 90% would survive, which is a much higher survival rate than you'd expect. So we're using the same approach to go after the coronavirus, or COVID-19. What we're doing is we've already immunized these mice, these magical mice. They've made antibodies. We've tested these antibodies. We've got thousands of them. Hundreds of them are neutralizing. That is, they can stop the virus from infecting cells. We're transferring these antibodies into our special cells that allow us to make these things on a massive scale. We'll move that up to our manufacturing plant, and we hope to start trials for that in around June to see if, and that could be, well, as you say, that could be like a vaccine, except as soon as you get the shot, you would be protected. You don't have to wait. Or it could actually be a treatment as well. If you have the virus, it could mop up that virus and help you get better.
But I just want to be precise, Dr. Schleifer. You think that within a month or so, you will have some new treatment that potentially could save the life of someone who was in a really severe case of the coronavirus?
Well, so the first one, what you're referring to, is a drug, Kevzara, which we developed with Sanofi as a rheumatoid arthritis drug. We are testing it now to see whether it can calm the inflammation in the lungs. There are all sorts of reports. It's become standard therapy, this class of drugs, in China. But we have to follow the scientific method. You know, my favorite president is Lincoln. Lincoln actually started and signed into law the National Academy of Sciences to advise the government. He knew that in times of crisis, we have to still follow the scientific way, and we're lucky to have people like Tony Fauci, the head of the FDA, people like Rick Bright at BARDA, who actually get the fact that they have to work with the scientific community. So yes, in miraculous time, we work with the FDA, we work with BARDA, and we work with Governor Cuomo, and we got trials up and running in New York in literally a matter of days, which normally would take 6 months or something. And yes, in a matter of a month or so, we should begin to see whether that could be really important in helping people who are very sick with the disease. That's still biology we have to solve. The more predictable path, I would have to say, is our monoclonal antibody, which will be a cocktail like it was for Ebola. It'll be a cocktail for this, but that we won't be able to start testing until June.
All right, well, Dr. Schleifer, thank you so much for what you and all your colleagues are doing at Regeneron. We're grateful to you. We'll stay, obviously, in close touch, and hopefully you guys will come up with some solutions fairly soon. There is so much at stake right now. Thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you, Wolf, and stay safe.
You too. Happening right now, the U.S. Senate is at work trying to negotiate a massive stimulus bill that could top $2 trillion. This as the pandemic triggers a wave of layoffs, with Goldman Sachs now estimating that a record 2 million people filed for unemployment last week alone. Joining us now, CNN International business correspondent Julia Chatterley. Julia.